Hey folks, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. Today I'm going to show you a model I designed a while back. This is the Picasso envelope. I like how when you pull this apart, the triangles get bigger and smaller, but it stays pretty much interlocked. And so yeah, it opens like this. It's from two sheets of paper and it slides out and you can house something inside, like a dollar. And then you can put it back. You just go in like this and slide it in, and then put flap inside, and it locks like that. All right, want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this model, I'm going to use 2 6-inch squares of kami, and the blue one is going to go inside of the violet one. So let's start with the blue one. Let's turn it over, and let's fold diagonally in half. Try to be as exact as possible. Pretty sharply. And unfold. And now let's take the left edge and fold it to the crease. Okay. And rotate 180 degrees. And now let's take this left edge and fold it to here. Make sure that it comes right to the corner. And you don't want them to overlap. If you can, just leave a minute hair in between. You see that white line? Okay. And pretty sharply. Okay. And now let's take the violet piece of paper and let's turn it over and fold diagonally in half. And unfold, and this time let's take the right edge and fold it to the crease. So we're making a mirror image of the blue one. And rotate 180 degrees, and let's fold this right edge to here. And once again, you want to leave a tiny hair. In fact, it could be a little bit bigger than the blue hair, although the same size is fine too. Okay. And now we are going to insert the blue one inside the violet one. So you might need to unfold this flap in order to get it inside. And how far should it slide inside? Slide it inside so that these two corners touch, so just like that. Okay, and oops, make sure that they touch exactly. Okay, you can also line up these two edges. Okay, unfold this flap, and let's take this edge and fold it right onto this edge. So we're just folding it up so that the two edges align. And you might want to leave a little hair right there. You definitely don't want to overlap it, but yes, a little hairline is fine. Okay? And let's fold this flap back, but this time let's stick it underneath this triangle. So just slide it under this triangle. Come on. Okay, there we go. And now let's take this flap, and this goes underneath this flap, like that. Okay, and our corners are still touching, good. And now let's rotate 90 degrees, and let's fold this flap up. We're going to fold this edge onto itself, so fold it up, but don't actually flatten yet. How far do you want to fold it up? You want to fold it up so that this edge touches this point. So just fold it up. Slide it up until this edge touches the point and make sure that these edges line up. So it's just like that. This should be rectangular. This should be rectangular, just like an envelope. Okay, let's rotate 180 degrees and let's do the same thing on this side. So let's fold this flap up. We're folding this edge onto itself, and we fold it up how far? We fold it up so that this edge touches the little blue triangle. So just like that. And let's rotate 180 degrees. And now let's fold this flap up. Once again, we're folding this edge onto itself, and we're folding it up so that the white triangle touches the blue triangle. So it's just like that. Make sure that the edge aligns. Just like that. Okay. And now let's rotate again, and let's unfold this flap, and unfold this flap, and let's slide them apart. Okay, so the blue one is the inside one, the violet one is the outside one. Let's work on the blue one, the inside one. So, this is really easy. All we have to do is we just have to change a little crease right here. So, unfold this flap, and fold this left flap in right on this crease, like that, and let's fold this flap back up right on this crease. And this one is all done. Okay, let's work on the violet one, the outside one. Let's unfold this flap, and now let's fold this corner in right on this crease that we made. So it's just like that. Crease it well, and fold this flap back down. Like that. Okay, now let's unfold this flap, and let's rotate, and let's fold this corner up right on this crease, so it folds up like this, and fold it up one more time on this crease. Like that, and let's rotate again, and let's fold this flap up right on this crease. And there we go. And now, we're going to stick the blue one. Well, let's rotate them all so that the blue one's on the right. Okay, well, let's put a dollar inside. So, let's turn it over top to bottom, and let's rotate so it's like this. And let's align the left edge with the left part right here, and the top with the top. Okay, and let's fold this up, fold it up straight. So how far do you want it to go? Well, you want it to go so that this corner touches this edge, or almost touches. So just like that. Okay, and now let's rotate again, and let's turn it over, and just stick it inside envelope, like this, and inside there, and it should fit nicely inside like that. Okay, and now let's put this back in. So we've aligned these two edges right here, and it goes inside, and you want to make sure that the blue one is on top, blue flap is on top. Goes in, and once it's like that, you straighten it out and press down here, and make the little flap come out like that. If it just goes in like this, well, you can just pull the blue flap out like that, and then stick the purple one inside like that. And there you have the envelope, and it slides open and close like that. Now, when you want to give this to somebody, and you don't want them to just unfold it, I mean, the whole purpose is that it pulls open like this. So what I recommend is drawing on it. Just put a circle right here with an arrow, meaning hold here and pull, and a circle about right here, and an arrow like that. So that means hold here and hold here and pull apart. And hopefully they'll at least get the idea that it's cool looking. And so it pulls open like that. Yeah. So there it is. All right. And there it is. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Yeah, I like it. It just, I like how the geometry changes, but it still stays kind of woven looking. So, all right. Well, I hope you guys like that, and see you next time. Bye-bye.